Ah, I'm ready to hunt some stuff. I'm ready to hunt dangerous things here on another rousing edition of Foreign Objects at Career Week. Hey, everyone. I'm Xav DeMatos. Thank you for joining us. On the line with me is Mr. Ludwig Kitzman.
Hello. What's up, buddy?
Future limo driver, by the way. That's
future limo driver. Luddy has proven himself worthy of having a license.
Are you sure a hunter is an occupation and not just a fervent pastime?
Well, here's the thing. I figure you get a job to put food on the table with the money that you make. I figured, let's cut out the middleman. Let me just get the food, put the food right on the table myself. I'll go grab it, drag it into the onto the table, and we'll put it on there, and then we'll eat it. I don't know exactly how it works, exactly. You know, we'll find boar so I can make bacon. And that's what getting a job is. You're making bacon, right? So this is day three. I am playing Cabela's Dangerous Hunts 2013. I am going to be hunting dangerous things, much like bears and or... Meese? Moose?
They're What's not, the pluralization of moose? They're just misunderstood.
They're misunderstood. They just want to hug you with their jaws. I just spilled my coffee. But we're going to roll with it anyway. If we're coming a little hot on the... wait, hold on. Let me make sure. Can you say something there?
Something there.
Something there. Perfect. I want to make sure everything's working. Let's go
really
into it.
Way to test, because I would likely say as you hunt something, there's something there. Shoot it.
Tim C in the chat is saying that these are a ton of graphics options in this game. Let's look at the graphics settings. Anti-aliasing, texture quality. Texture quality is not high or low. It's yes or no, by the way, in this game. Do you want texture quality? Oh, go for it. Depth of field. I assume we're going to be in a lot of fields, so I'd like to have some depth in them.
Yeah, and like then, they shouldn't just be like shallow and two-dimensional, right? I want them to be really well-written characters.
So there are multiple options in this game. There's story mode, man-eater mode, play single-player cooperative split-screen arenas, and then there's also shooting galleries. I feel like let's save the story mode for a moment.
Yeah, I don't want to be spoiled when I play this game.
Yeah, let's do a shooting gallery. We're going to play one-player shooting gallery. Arcade or
What's
reflex?
What's your problem with galleries?
Oh, man. I don't know. We're going to find out.
Some really nice paintings in galleries.
Where do we want to go? Burning Savannah? The Swamp? Hot Sands? Let's go to the Swamp.
You don't want to go to Green Namibia?
Oh, we're saving it. We're saving it all. Options. We're going to play with keyboard. That's what we're going to do. I don't
that
know why I
have
this controller.
That is the most realistic.
Yeah, I want realism. I want to make sure I can do this in real life if I decide to become some sort of hunter. By the way, I'm wearing my Mortal Kombat Hospitality t-shirt. I don't know if you can see that. It's Raiden and Sub-Zero at a dinner table, and it says Hospitality. Let's play Dangerous Hunts.
Hospitality.
Loading the swamp right now.
You didn't set your sensitivity high enough. You're not going to be affected by the death of these animals. You're not going to be emotional enough. You need to up the sensitivity.
I'm waiting for the Paragon choices to come up later for me to decide. Oh, Jesus, that was a loud sound effect. This is an on-rail shooter, by the way. Let's turn down these sound options before they destroy my eardrums. Let's just turn down the sound. Just
That would happen in real life. I thought you were taking this job hunt seriously.
But I would have like protective gear and goggles. I would have some sort of a trucker hat wearing like a camouflage thing on me. Maybe some like leaves to protect me from some stuff.
Hunting.
Start hunting! Oh man! Oh, I just shot that boar directly in the face. Damn it! Hunt animals in the right order.
Wait,
for
is
bonus
that not what
points.
You're supposed to do? Are you not supposed to shoot a boar directly in the face?
Yes.
I got a free shooting mode. Yeah! Success! This dude is super pumped about how I'm doing in this. Because now I have to hunt crocodiles and birds.
Is there a fire somewhere here? Is that why all the animals are fleeing in front of you? This is like people on either side of you shooing them into the line of fire.
Oh man, I missed the birds! Duh, it rewinds time. If I screw up. Oh, I know these crocodile patterns.
Free shooting.
This feels like a game I should be pumping quarters into. Alright, now I'm hunting wild boar and deer. You have to do these in order, okay? You have to make sure. Whenever you hunt, you need to make sure you do it in order, or else you are not allowed to take any of the game with you.
Yes.
Oh man, that thing got shot directly in the face.
Reshooting. A true hunter.
I just got called a true hunter. I may have found my calling.
And the sound effects of the menu selections are... They make it feel like a very... Like the game that you would find in the arcade. Like it's like on a cabinet.
Yes. All right.
And I think that might actually make it.
Whew! I just gotta kill myself a crocodile. Kill myself a croc.
Now that was a hunt.
I'm getting accolades here, man. I'm feeling good about my hunting skills. Wild boar, deer, wild boar. In that order. Let's do it.
Well done.
Oh, the camera keeps moving! Damn it. Alright, well. I didn't do it in the order they wanted, but I got it done. Things got God, if you know what I'm saying. Man, they're just throwing all the animals at me now. I'm gonna kill a wild boar, a deer, another wild boar, and a bird.
Well done.
Oh, a bird?
Got it! Illustrations, just in case you get confused over which one is the bird.
Now that was a hunt.
I feel like I should be fleeing with the animals in a particular direction. They do seem like they know what they're doing.
I don't know, they seem really disorganized. They clearly need someone to show them.
They're very concerned about what's happening in the world right now. Okay, what am I doing? Wild boar. Damn it! Oh!
Wild boar. What you gonna do?
Damn it! Didn't get that bird.
Let's hit it.
What is the crocodile doing out here?
Well done. Yes.
Oh, I guess there's a source of water. It makes sense. But even for him to come out all the way to grab you instead of just luring you into having a nice sip of water and grabbing you by the neck.
Yeah.
Is the usual strategy.
Oh man, this guy just got deep on me. He just said, "Your aim was true." Man, all right, we're gonna do this last round, and then we're gonna see what man eater mode is. Maybe you get to play as the man eaters. You play as Nelly Furtado in the next version. All right, wild boar, deer, wild boar. Okay, here we go.
You have to bookend it with wild boars.
That's tough.
Ah!
I really like the graphic that they use for the crocodile. He's like, "Hey." Why'd you shoot me?
Oh no, I messed that up. Alright, I gotta get into it. I gotta get into the zone.
Go.
Well, I think you are within a legal hunting zone.
Alright. Well done.
Alright, well, I just gotta hit a boar now.
Free shooting.
Whew. I'm like, this is intense. I just unlocked an achievement. It says, "You have survived," which is like the opposite of Resident Evil when you die. I wish Resident Evil told you that at the end of
every level. The next level has T-virus variants of all of these animals.
Tim C in chat says, "This isn't hunting, this is rampage." Oh man. That was play again or quit. I'm gonna go ahead and quit. So that was the swamp. I guess different animals appear in different...
That was like on-site job training, but now
that was
the real thing.
Let's do... What is this? Splits arenas. Let's go man-eater mode. Single player. The gate. Overwatch. Trapdoor. These are the names of the maps, which sounds suspiciously like Halo maps. The gate. Overwatch. Trapdoor. Snowfall. Jungle Rumble. These do sound like maps
all
you'd
with
find.
With the exception of Jungle Rumble.
Jungle Rumble, yeah. Ooh, I could do a scout and sniper match in Overwatch.
You need something. Go somewhere that has lions.
You want to go hit up some lions? All right, we'll go to.
I'm rooting for the lions, just so you know.
I feel like in Snowfall, there'd be like snow leopards. Let's do it.
Or Tigatron from Beast Wars.
It's possible. All of these things are possible here. I'm legitimately into round this one. Right now. Oh man, it's like... Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh, you got shot directly in the face. How are you still alive?
I love that your directive in this is hunt all animals.
Oh, man. Oh, I can tuck and roll.
Are you using a sniper? It's not a sniper rifle. It's a sniper rifle.
But like, it's not on rails anymore, like so I don't have to...
You need a shotgun at this range. I'm just applying like first person.
Oh, wait. I do have a shotgun.
This is kind of reminiscent of Lost Ring 3.
Oh!
One animal left to hunt.
Let's go. Yeah!
This still doesn't seem like hunting.
Wait, this is exactly what hunting's like. Come on. Real Sally in chat says that this is Cabela. Next round starts in 6
Cabela
seconds.
Wombat evolved.
Oh, and I have a desert. I have a deagle here, desert eagle. I got a crossbow. Oh, there's a lion here. Ah! Tuck and roll. Jesus! These things are like 3 times my size, by the way.
Basically, you're under attack from the Avengers of the Animal Kingdom.
Oh no!
So would it really take this many shots?
I don't know, but I just crossbowed. Wait. Ugh!
Also, a real hunter wouldn't let himself be trapped in an arena like this.
Only one to go.
Oh, I got I'm a crossbow expert now. Woo! Complete. Things got intense here, folks. Tim C wants to know when the honey badger is about to show up. That would be the boss monster in this game is the honey badger. Let's not.
Yeah, that is the most evil of all animals.
All right, we're gonna do another round of this, and then we're gonna see what the story mode's all about. I'm interested. I want to know the intricate stories that are involved with this video game. All right, I don't have that much
we have a ammo honey left. We have a honey badger apologist in the chat, real styly.
Get ready.
He says the eagles were the real pain. I mean, they were. They would surprise you.
Woo! Oh, I hear something behind me. What the hell? Here we go. Woo! How do I tuck and roll again? I'm not doing it. Oh, there we go. This game's amazing. Oh, come on. I shot you directly in the face with a sniper rifle. How are
That's
you still alive?
That's where the
alive?
Most powerful skull bone is. If I remember
directly in the face?
Correctly, yeah. The wolf skull helm
one animal left to hunt.
Would prevent immediate death from being shot in the face.
Yeah! I'm gonna...
I feel like you're really haphazardly switching weapons, so you're just sort of trying them all.
I'm sort of just trying to figure things out right now. I'm trying to see what, if I became a hunter, what would be my go-to. I feel like you need to master one before you can really open up the toolbox.
Oh, you failed to find the key. Why is there a key also?
I don't know. I think you're actually looking for the Forerunner technology in this video game. Find and repair the radios is my new mission. Oh, come on, I tucked and rolled.
You lower the game volume just a teensy bit.
Sure.
But first you have to repair the radios, it's really important.
What do we want to lower? The sound?
I think the sound of music just a little bit.
The music?
Probably it's the music more than that. The music.
All right, I'll just. The music is already on the last one, so I'm just going to turn the music completely off. It'll add tension. Oh, come on, come on, come on, come on. Woo!
See, now I can hear the howling wind, which makes it way creepier. I think that wolf just dodged your shot. Like his defenses were so amped up that you can even shoot him with a
weapon. Man!
Oh boy.
The aiming in this is not ideal. Okay, where's the radio?
Oh, so the aiming in real life is not ideal? Is that what you're going to say when you get mauled by wolves?
Oh, Jesus! You have to think of
them as aggressive pelts. That's all.
Oh, there's like ammo in the world that I can collect. Can I tuck and roll forward?
You've been bitten by wolves like 50 times, and you're still alive. That's impressive.
I'm resilient, man.
Are you wearing like one of those dog training outfits?
I don't know what is happening anymore. Wait, where's this radio? I don't see no damn radio. Oh, I just got a health pack, though. Here we go. How do I hold F to repair? Thirty seconds left to repair all these radios, guys. Can we do it? So close to repairing the radio!
You still have shotgun ammo?
Whew! I did it! Now I have to hunt all animals!
Hunt all animals. Does that include man?
the wildest animal of them all, am I right?
Yeah, the deadliest animal.
This guy's super jazzed about killing things. Yes! Ah! I got all the radios, and I hunted all the animals. Is there a melee attack? I don't think so. I'm going to look it up now. Now I want to know if there's melee.
Activate the QTEs.
There is no way for me to actually... Oh, view
layout.
Those
wolves are QTEs.
Hunter's Eye. There's a thing called Hunter's Eye. There's a Killer Instinct mode.
Killer Instinct mode sounds crunchy.
We're gonna go to the story mode here in a second. I just want
to
see.
Yeah, I would like to see what the story is.
Hunter is like slow-mo.
Behind this hunter.
Oh, I think it actually shows me where things are in the world. And Killer Instinct mode was V, and that's not doing nothing.
Round 5. Safety off.
Hunter. Round 5. Safety off is exactly what you just said. I would appreciate if the menu didn't cover up most of the game here. Oh! Come on. Hunter mode? Where is it? God! I love the animation when they die. They just like flop. They flop around. Here we go. Come on. Tuck and roll.
You should also try ducking and covering.
Duck and cover. And cover. Duck and cover. Oh. Here we go. Man, this tiger is taking some damage. Where'd he go? They just disappear, so I don't know if I've actually killed them, if I don't see them disappearing in the right time. The boss is coming! There is a boss battle in this video game. I need to know what that wolf just jumped out of my way.
Well, I mean, he doesn't want to die. It's a survival instinct. In the wolf world, they have video games where you have to just, it's like a Dark Souls kind of thing, where you have to survive hunters coming for you.
Tim C. in chat says, the wolves are huge, they're like wargs in, I'm assuming he's trying to make a Game of Thrones reference. They're not, I don't think they're called, are they called wargs in Game of Thrones?
I don't think so.
Oh, I have to save who's on the ground.
The people who, can see through the eyes of animals.
Yeah, those are wargs.
Those are wargs, yes.
What are the actual wolves called? What is ghost in that universe?
They're called dire wolves.
Dire wolves, that's it. Alright, well, how do I protect it? This guy's just, like, doing snow angels. Like, dude, get up! Dude! Oh, man, it's like, I am haphazardly changing weapons. Where's this boss that I was promised? Ugh. I'm coming after you! I will tuck and roll all over your dead body! There we go. 30 seconds left. This guy is an expert in reloading this shotgun. Whew.
20 seconds left.
You know, something crazy happened while we've been streaming this.
What happened?
There's a Kickstarter for a new Toe Jam and Earl game.
What? I guess we can support those now.
I don't know if we can support them for a Toe Jam and Earl game.
Well, the last one wasn't any indication that they knew what they were doing.
I think it was by different people, though.
Oh, it probably was.
It was an extremely weird game.
That OG... OG Toe Jam and Earl is my jam. I love that. It's an era of a game where you can... That I feel like is coming back in some strange way, where it's like this...
Games with racist lead characters.
Oh, man. No. Games that give you zero information and expect you to do very intricate planning.
Real Siley says, I was hoping their boss was a Yeti.
Oh, God, if the boss was... Why haven't I not seen the boss
yet? I believe he would be called an abominable snowman in this game. I don't think they would use slang like Yeti.
Yeah, that's Yeti's his rap
Yeti
name.
Survives.
Yeti's his name on the streets. That's what he goes by as a DJ.
Could be a double Yeti, like in Futurama.
Like, I appreciate that they're trying to give me information, but...
When does this mode end?
when does life end, man? Really? Like,
well, it's because you haven't found the key. Go find the key unlocks the end of this mode.
they're just throwing every single animal in the world at me right now. All right, let's.
Is this like? Are you actually a park ranger or a park manager, and this is how they do culling of animals? Is they throw them all into an arena with one person?
Oh, come on. Tuck and roll. Nice! Alright, we're gonna go up to where it says a thing to do to go in this direction. Yeah, I just got an athlete achievement. Run faster! Cool. Oh god, I hear growling behind me.
That's the hungry wolf.
Hungry like a wolf. Okay, did I find the key? Press F to pick up key. I got the key! Use the key! More information required! I need...
Assume that there is a door of some kind, perhaps a lock attached to it.
I'm going to go to where I believe doors are located.
Maybe it's just a like symbolic key. Like, it's the key to your victory. Try throwing the key at the wolves. Maybe that's what they want.
Okay, well, I use the key to open these pens. One animal left to hunt.
The pen is not going
to
help you. You need to stick with the guns.
Well, I found the key and I used the key.
Unless
your
choice is between the pen and the sword, in which case you should go with the pen.
Well, it is mightier.
The pen does more DPS.
Can I jump? Oh, I can jump. Can I go on? I cannot jump high enough to go on top of these like waste leveled boxes though. Oh, where did you come from? Wait, I think this is the boss monster.
Hunt the targeted animals. I feel like you've been targeting all animals.
Yeah, there we go.
Is the target dog gonna show up?
Oh, when I stop moving, I get... Oh!
Your accuracy goes up when you stop moving?
Yeah, it's realistic like that. The boss is coming!
I feel like... There would be a movie adaptation of the man who survived this arena. Just like, have you heard the story of the man who
I feel like Bradley in, Cooper in is prepping for this role right now.
And was attacked by 800 wolves.
800 wolves that are of, like, ginormous animals. Wait, the boss is coming. I have one wolf left. Challenge complete. It keeps teasing me with this boss. Come on, man. How many wolves are in the pack? Teflon asks. All of them. Next round starts in 13 seconds.
Round survived.
Oh, so I need keys to open
up
these.
You didn't really impress them, you just survived.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know if I'm doing... I think I'm...
Is this an endless mode? Are you sure it's not endless mode?
It'll never end for me, man. This is my job training.
I think it's just a part of life for you.
Oh, God! We're gonna go into the story mode just as soon as I want to see what this boss is. It keeps telling me a boss is coming, and I don't see no boss. Oh, God! Tuck and roll! Whew! Oh, man, I'm a crossbow ninja right now.
A real ninja would never use a crossbow. He would use kunai and poison.
Wait, I need to pick up a key. I got a key.
Smoke grenades.
I'm going to open this thing because I got a key. I feel like a kid who goes hunting with his dad and is like just trying to impress him. I got the key. I got the key, Dad.
Also, I slaughtered 800 wolves.
I feel like there's got to be some sort of like limitation in like statewide where it's you can't kill this many wolves and think that you can get away with it.
Or expect the species to continue thriving.
I want the end of this mode to just say, species wiped out, congratulations.
No, I think someone like from the environmental board should arrest you. Slap him in irons.
Oh, sweet lord. That is a lot of wolves. Hunt the legendary predator. Holy shit, that's a bear! Tuck and roll! Run! Oh, God! This thing is huge. Oh, and he... Oh, it just turned into a QTE mode.
The bear of war.
Oh god. I just killed him. I just killed a legendary animal.
I've never heard of him.
King Kong ain't got nothing on me.
Achievement unlocked. Extinction, says MC42.
I feel like I have a future in arena-style wolf hunting. Oh,
I think
man.
Someone said earlier that this is kind of like the arena in Far Cry 4.
I'm fairly.
I said you had to fight people in that one too, and you were naked.
Oh, I won. I beat the mode. It was 10 rounds to survive, and I beat the mode.
And it was never played again.
All right, we got to see the story mode. I'm sorry. Like, it needs to happen. Start new. Let's look at level select. Different. I was hoping I could scroll through them to see all of the different names for the levels, because so far the names for the maps are pretty phenomenal. Okay, let's go. It's loading. Taking the shot.
Take the shot.
Teflon, I thought the legendary predator was man. I'm fairly certain this cutscene was directed by Hideo Kojima, by the way.
Oh, so we're going to be here for a while.
Loving shots of grass.
So it's important to establish the scene.
It is.
The crime scene. Oh, look at how cute that guy is. You can't shoot him.
Oh, it's getting right into it.
Don't do it.
Okay, it says press and hold left shift to hold breath. And it's not actually doing it. Oh, wait. Okay, there we go. Oh, it shows an outline of their organs.
You must destroy the dark doe before it plunges the light into darkness.
Oh man, you can see like their internal organs.
This is making me uncomfortable.
Should I just, can I like put my weapon down and
the conscientious objector? That's actually how you get the true ending of the game. It's like,
the achievement is called Conscientious Objector.
Yeah, exactly. It's like, I'm sorry, sir. I refuse to kill the Bambis. I don't want to do it. I'm passing the buck. On to you.
Here we go. You've got to take the shot. Critical vital shot! That's what he just said. I think it's going to cut to Bambi. Oh man, that was the cold open. Now we're late title card action on Cabela's Dangerous Hunts 2013. Real styly. Passing the buck? LOL.
So stylish.
Cabela's Dangerous Hunts 2013. A few months later, you know, after we've processed what's happened.
After you've processed the meat.
I don't want to be a jerky about it. So. Oh boy, there's three people here now, and this is the first time I'm seeing that guy in the middle. I'm sure he's the red shirt. He's gonna die. This entire story is gonna be hunting down the bear that kills him.
Some kind of event has to highlight the dangers of hunting. Maybe this is a Star Trek episode.
Oh no. Oh my god, I just totally called the story of this game. There's a bear that showed up and he's totally going to kill one of the family
that
members.
That guy has a helmet made out of hair. He should be fine.
These look like the Double Dragon Brothers, but in Cabela's Dangerous Hunt. That bear is booking it.
And not get over that hair at all.
He's like Bieber.
It looks like it's like the Lego figure hair. Like it could just detach.
Yeah, just slap it right on. Fixate right on top of it. It's funny because the voice volume is lower than the sound volume, so all I really hear is wind. We're on the other side. Cross over. I'm out of ammo. Shh,
way to go, Einstein. I got more in my pack. Just catch up. Dang it. I'm sure they got an excellent voice cast for this game. This is probably like Patrick Stewart, Troy Baker, Nolan North, Jennifer Hale.
I'm hearing. I think Jennifer Hale plays one of the wolves.
Katie Sackhoff.
Oh man, I just fell randomly.
Trisha Helfer.
Just how many actors can you name?
Mark Meer.
No, Nathan Fillion plays.
Yuri Lowenthal.
Whoa. Look at how twitchy these plants are. What the hell?
Use your hunter's eye.
My hunter's eye tells me that I have to follow these arrows, because that's literally what shows up
also
when you
known
use...
as your eye.
They made it seem like I was in a dire situation. I had no ammo, and I had to go find my brother.
I had no idea that hunters were superhumans.
Apparently.
Real Sally says Nathan Fillion plays the buck.
Yeah.
And Tim C42 says, looks like my high school hair.
Jennifer Hale plays the expended shells of your weapon. It's just her going... through the sky, cutting through
Oh, you said expended shells? I thought you said, like, expended shells. Like, expendables. Also, the expendables.
Expendables. Isn't that a thing that they're actually doing?
That is, yes. For some reason. I mean, I'm going to watch it, but...
What just happened? Picked up ammo. Let's activate this mode and see.
Because we've established that it's your dad and brother.
Yeah, and your dad's kind of a dick. He's, like, yelling at his sons. And my brother keeps leaving me behind.
Right, so they'll probably be destroyed. I mean, given the usual emotional setup that they go for in these video games.
They will be killed by their own
hubris.
They'll
be killed, and then you'll, like, the bear will have some kind of identifying mark on it, like a scar or something. An off-colored patch of fur. And you'll make it your life's quest to avenge them.
Well, it showed me a bear that had a scarred face, so I feel like they're trying to do character development.
Shot that wolf in the heart, that's impressive.
Yeah. Listen,
I'm not really getting a sense of how lucrative this is yet. I mean, you're certainly getting a lot of points. I just don't know how much money you're getting.
Tutorial tips. The pack will scatter if you take down the alpha in one shot to the vitals. If not, or if the pack gets too close, they will attack. It's like they know. It's like, what? It took them 3 shots to kill our alpha. Get him! Like, I don't understand how that makes much
the
of a
hunter
difference.
We're trying to eat is clearly amateur.
Got him in one shot. Scattered. Now I gotta find my brother and father. Oh, they're closing in on the grizzly bear. This is gonna go poorly for this family. I feel like at the end we're gonna find out who the real monster is. Ooh, I could pick up... There's collectibles in the game. There are 39 antlers to pick up. Just to let you know. For all you achievement hunters. The bear's close. There's my brother who keeps running off without me. Because he's a douchebag. With a Bieber haircut.
Say Bieber or Beaver? Because I feel like Beaver haircuts could be a thing in this game.
It's possible. Oh my, I called it. The bear has officially murdered our father. This is now a revenge plot.
No.
It's hard for me to take the emotion seriously with this hair. It actually kind of looks like they walked in on their father and bear like in a really sexual position. Because they're like laying on top of each other. It's like they fell asleep. It's kind of creepy. Now it's 10 years later. Oh, you can tell it's later because now I have a goatee, so it's good. That's how you know the things he's had trouble in his life, because now he has a goatee. And now we're in the savannah, I think?
Yeah, it's really far away. It took them 10 years to get there.
Yeah, they've been walking this whole time. It's been a trek. It's been a journey. Oh my god, we've just revealed that my character, whose name is Jacob, by the way, is a conservationist. He's conserving bullets and storing them neatly inside of skulls.
He's conserving the human race by wiping out all the other animals.
By every animal.
Human conservationist.
I would love for him to get out of this car and then he gets his luggage and it's just like a bear stuffed. And then that's where he puts all his luggage instead of a stuffed bear and he's rolling it around. This guy is driving like a
maniac. I'm going to go further and call it like so. He is supposed to show us the benefits of forgiveness, because he still loves animals and he'll shoot them on occasion when it comes down to calling situations, mm-hmm. You know, but his brother will be driven by revenge,
So, Real Style asks, like, how are you supposed to avenge your dad's death? Do you kill, like, all the bears in the world? Since you've already killed... Since your dad killed that one bear already? Oh, man, this thing is... Get out of here. Time to take life by the horns. I'm killing all these... Oh, God, leopards! Oh, shoot him in the face! I just shot that leopard.
The Lion King, that's where they're going. Mufasa's death scene.
Vital shot in that leopard's face is a thing that just happened.
This doesn't really... This is not the most convincing African savannah I've seen.
Oh, man.
Like, those trees aren't really...
Wait,
I think it's the light. The light doesn't look quite right.
So I got rammed by a bull, and then there was a long pause, and then a menu popped up that just said, "You have been killed." That's all. It just says, "You have been killed." Blastoise in chat says, "Man, you conserved the shit out of that leopard." We're going to restart this checkpoint. I feel like we have a lot of conservation to do right now. Oh, the checkpoint is the beginning of the level? No. Well, we're skipping.
They were pretty conservative with the checkpoints.
Oh, this game is glorious.
Well, at least I got the baobab trees right. That was an impala right at the beginning, by the way. That's where you're running.
Am I driving a Chevy Impala? Is that what's
happening? No, you're chasing one.
Alright. We're always chasing the Impala. Let's name my autobiography. Let's go. Oh, reload faster, you monster! Whew.
I should this go direct if it's weapon. Just escape the sandstorm. It says nothing about...
Well, they keep ramming the vehicle, so I'm assuming.
Here we go.
I love the physics in this game.
For water buffalo.
Here we go. We're doing this.
Also, you're actually really lucky to see leopards, because they're pretty tough to find on safaris. So the fact that you get to not only see some, but kill them...
They are coming after me, though.
Which does not make any sense.
I feel like this is them just trying to be playful.
Like, is it part of the story, like, to explain why animals are so unusually aggressive? Is it, like, the happening?
Yeah, this is... It says press up to... Press F to pick up health pack. I don't know. I'm in a vehicle. Where did the health pack come from?
It's in the glove compartment.
Oh, there's a rhino! It just flipped our truck, and now I'm action moving it at the side of the truck, at the side of the car here. Oh man, this game is rad. This game is super rad and realistic. This is exactly how hunting happens. I feel like this is more of a roller coaster than anything else.
Cinematic hunting game.
Did I die? Oh, you have been killed again? Oh, man. This is 10 times of awesome right here.
You didn't duck. You should have ducked.
I'm going to duck right now.
You have been killed by a concussion.
You have been killed by your height. Are there a lot of sandstorms of this nature in Africa? In South Africa, from where you're from?
I wouldn't say there's a lot. I mean, I think it's totally dependent on the soil and... weather and how often it's rained, that kind of thing. But you would never be chased by leopards and ones who were trying to kill you as you drove off.
Hey, I press space, what the hell? Oh, shot in the face. I love the physics. The Havoc physics engine is being utilized. Fully, to its full potential here.
This is probably what it was born to do.
This was it. Alright, where are we going now?
At career day for physics engines, they said you have to simulate dead animal bodies.
Oh no. I just hit a tree that all the leopards were in. Shot that leopard in the heart.
The leopard nest.
Here we go. What's next? Oh, I'm just shooting y'all in the heart. This man hates animals. I don't know why he could call himself a...
This is all self-defense. This is totally...
This is all self-defense. I want to see the bodies left in his wake.
Who's driving? I'm going to be the driver at this co-op game.
Oh, get out of here, Rhino!
Wow.
I love how I have to shoot the wooden planks or else we can be killed.
Rhinos are endangered. I don't approve of you killing them.
Jesus, something giant just jumped past me.
Well, there's only so many things it could be.
I don't know, man. This might be where they pull up the stops.
What are these ruins? Why are there ruins here?
I don't know. I mean, when you wanna destroy animals, you gotta do them in fancy locales.
Why are they falling apart? Besides, you know...
The sandstorm?
Drama.
They're being destroyed by the dramatic tension.
By the production values.
I just randomly shooting.
It's like a pretty slick-looking hunting game. I don't know why the story mode has taken this form. It doesn't really seem... very hunting-y. But maybe they're quiet open world pods.
Oh yeah, this is the cold open. Oh, elephants! I'm not shooting no elephants. Oh, it's making me shoot elephants!
Ooh.
I don't like this game at all. Uh-oh. I just fell out of the truck. This is where nature's gonna take its revenge on me. There's a lot of unnecessary death.
What is this rickety bridge here?
Teflon leaning out the side like a safari gangsta. That was ridiculous. Oh, I love how no one was injured in that at all.
Apparently, it doesn't seem like there was a driver. It's okay. So this is like a Far Cry 2 vehicle. Just like tweak it with a wrench a little bit, and it should be fine.
Mm-hmm. We're going to try to get to this ranger station, and then, I'm going to tell you, man,
Mr. Order in the chat is asking, do you get arrested in the game for shooting endangered animals?
We're going to find out. We're going to go to the ranger station.
You have immunity because you are a conservationist.
we're going to go to the ranger station and turn ourselves in. That's what we're going to do. Whoa, I just heard something. Oh, man, you can do the tuck and roll on this, too. This game is... outstanding. Oh boy. This thing doesn't seem too happy that I killed all of its friends. Q. Whoa!
Okay, so this is basically Call of Duty.
Yes.
With animals.
Yeah.
I was expecting like a slow-paced hunting game. Simulation.
That opening sequence was a little bit like the airport level in the last Call of Duty game. The really horrific airport level. Jesus.
I thought we agreed that there was a moratorium on enemies and video game enemies that charge you and then you shoot them in the back.
He stopped charging me and I'm still just firing at him. Yeah, hunting with this Desert Eagle that's bigger than me. All right, we're at the ranger station here. I'm going to tell you, I think I got a future in hunting. I feel like I can stop pronouncing the G on all ING games.
I think you have a future in this sort of action hunting that doesn't exist in real life.
Oh, man, there's an animal. Shh, be very quiet. Very quiet. So I can shoot him with this handgun. Oh, right in the face! That was awful.
They're collectible antlers?
They're collectible antlers. Yeah. Hey, man. Progression system? Uh-oh. Hyenas. Threat indicator warns of predators attacking you from behind. That would have been wonderful to know earlier. Press V to activate Killer Instinct mode. Oh, that's how that works. Okay. Whew. Got him. Hyenas are no match for me.
Now who's the laughing stock?
Wait, something's behind me, I think. I hear growling. Jesus!
Press V to activate Killer Instinct.
Ultra combo! Keep running! I'm hitting V, and no Killer Instinct was activated.
Maybe you have to wait until something leaps at you.
It said when that icon showed up that I could do it, but... Let's do this. Where is it?
I think hyenas would just wait for something else to kill you and then come eat your body.
I think so, right? They don't seem this brazen in reality.
It's in a world gone mad. All the animals just want you dead.
Well, I mean, they just read the Animal Times and they saw the horrific animal carcasses I left in my wake. Jesus! I picked up special ammunition. I don't know why it's so special.
Because it was found lying in the Sahara. What's Serengeti is what I'm going to say. Seems pretty special. Are there any exploding barrels?
I feel like that's the mark of quality for this game. Alright, well, I meant to reload, but I ended up just tucking and rolling. Oh, here we go. I'm inside. Investigate and search for a key. And some firearms.
What? Why?
What the hell is that noise? This just turned into a horror game. Alright, I just found a shotgun. And now some, like, really disgusting looking hyena boss animal just appeared to terrify
me.
It's
the super hyena.
This is like the game that doesn't know what genre it's supposed to be in.
Someone has been experimenting on wildlife. Okay, kind of reminds me of that bear in Condemned 2.
Wait, where am I supposed to go?
A real hunter would know.
Wait. Alright. Oh, I didn't find the key.
You found a bolt action rifle.
I found a bolt. I mean, I have a shotgun.
The only bolt action I would use in this scenario is to bolt in the opposite direction.
Of all the animals attempting to murder you. Oh, F to open. I found cans of food. Escape the ranger station. I feel like this is where shelter is. Why would I want to escape? Alright.
Well, there's no food. No canned food. Nothing like that.
Oh man, the hyenas have infiltrated. This is an elite squad of hyenas.
Hyena is in there with you. The lofts are coming from within the ranger station. Also, the scale of them seems completely wrong. They seem gigantic. Unless you're a really small person.
I am. You are playing as Peter Dinklage in this video game. Oh, tuck and roll!
Also, why do the bodies disappear, do you think? What's going to be the narrative explanation for that?
It's sort of like that.
That's what the special bullets are in your gun. Like they.
I feel like that's what the Spec Ops storyline of this game is, that you're going to realize that these aren't actually animals, but
they were people like, all along.
It's like the MASH ending. It wasn't a chicken; it was a baby. Oh God, this is horrible. I think that's going to do it for Cabela's The Dangerous Hunts. I feel like if I had to be a hunter,
the stream is over just because you cannot play this game.
I just can't do it anymore. I tried so hard, just so hard to play Cabela's Dangerous Hunts 2013. I feel like if push came to shove and I needed to put food on the table and there were a lot of wolves attacking me or hyenas in Los Angeles, maybe I could do it. Maybe. But as long as I have unlimited ammunition.
Your opinion of actors isn't that low. You wouldn't call them hyenas.
I've met quite a few out here, actually. Well, that's going to do it for the stream. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for watching live on twitch.tv/foreignobjects. You can follow us on Twitter at Foreign Show, F-O-R-E-I-G-N-S-H-O-W on Twitter. We will announce what we're going to be playing next. And you can also, if you're on twitch.tv/foreignobjects, you can go on the bottom of the channel and there are links to our YouTube channel where you can subscribe and get our archives and highlights and some new videos that we're going to be doing over the next little while. Luddy, thank you very much for joining us. What are we doing tomorrow? I know what I'm going to be playing tomorrow for day 4 of Career Week. I'm going to be playing The Master Plan, which will put me in the shoes of a couple of criminals where we plan bank robberies and other jobs. It's actually kind of a fun little indie
game.
That's
actually not a job. That's what you do when you don't want to work for a living.
That's actually, you know, I mean, I feel like teamwork is a compelling skill that I should be learning. Crafting intricate, detailed plans and plots. These are all things that will work for project management, maybe, in the future. Are you going to be a surgeon tomorrow, maybe?
Maybe.
Maybe. We'll find out tomorrow, right here, on Foreign Objects. Thanks, everyone, for watching, and we'll see you then tomorrow, 11 a.m. Pacific. Bye.
Bye.